Placido Domingo 先生首次访华演出，与我国音乐界、新闻界会见和艺术交流会现在开始。首先，请文化部副部长刘德友同志讲话。
尊敬的多明戈先生及夫人，尊敬的大使阁下，女士们、先生们、朋友们、同志们。
Y señores, amigos y camaradas.
世界著名的男高音歌唱家普拉西多多明戈先生来到我国，今天同我国首都音乐家、新闻界会见，并且进行艺术交流，我们感到十分高兴。我仅代表中国文化部、中国音乐家协会以及首都新闻界向多明戈先生表示热烈欢迎和衷心感谢。
gran palacio del pueblo, el señor va a representar al mundo con los artistas del grupo de antología de la zarzuela de España. El debut del señor Domingo en China escribirá una página brillante en la historia del intercambio cultural entre China y España. La representación del señor constituirá una oportunidad preciosa de aprendizaje para músicos chinos y una oportunidad incomparable de goce artístico para el público de nuestro país.
bollenti spiriti, il giovani l'ardore, nella tempro col placido sorriso dell'amor, dal dice di sé vivere, io voglio te quasi in ciel, da lì che disse vivere, io voglio a te fedela, sì, dell'universo in me.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It is for me a great emotion to be in your country, to sing for you for the very first time. This is only after a few hours arriving in Peking. I'm going to be, as you well know, singing after tomorrow and the following day with the Antología de la Zarzuela. And this is just trying to be with you and say hello and tell you how wonderful is your country. I was singing now the part of Alfredo in La Traviata, which is by chance the very first opera I was singing, and of course is one of the colossal of the opera repertoire, Giuseppe Verdi, who wrote Traviata. I want to go now from Traviata to the one of the last operas of Verdi, which certainly has been one of the great roles for me around the world, which combines the maestry and the big combination of two great men of the music and the literature together, which is Giuseppe Verdi plus Shakespeare, combining the big, big talents in Otello. It has been for me one of the greatest roles. So from the very young part of Alfredo, I want to go now to Otello, which is certainly the part that I love the most. I'm going to sing for you the last scene from Otello, Niun mi tema.
You
As you well know, I'm going to sing after tomorrow my music, the music which I knew when I was a little boy, even before, because my parents used to sing this Spanish music, which it is very powerful, very happy one, very dramatic one, which is called La Zarzuela. I'm going to sing now for you an aria that is very, very dear for me, from a zarzuela, from one of our great composers, which is still is alive, Pablo Sorozabal, a great composer which is 91 years old, and it's a work called La Tabernera del Puerto, and I'm going to sing an aria called No Puede Ser. Thank you. Now, before I will have the pleasure of listening to the young singers, I am going to sing one song that is very, very international. It is a song dedicated to one of the most beautiful cities of the world, which is a city that is in Spain. And it was written from a Mexican composer, which my wife is Mexican and I spent a lot of my life in Mexico. The composer is Agustín Lara, and the song, it is very popular, and I think that you all know it. It is Granada.
Sangre y de
I can feel very much that you are going to enjoy the zarzuela after tomorrow. It is such a warm public, so enthusiastic. I know you will love the Spanish music after tomorrow. I'm going to announce now some of your young singers, which I'm very anxious to hear. First of all, singing from the opera Mephistopheles, from Arrigo Boito, the aria L'altra notte in fondo al mare, the soprano Yang Xiaoping. translate this for me. I have been asked if I can give a lesson to the singers, but I think I'm going to refuse because either I give lessons or I sing, but I cannot do both things in an evening. When I'm singing also, I don't think it's fair that I'm giving lessons because we all have something to learn, and maybe I learned something from the singers also. So I think for what I have heard now, we have a wonderful, wonderful singers, and I'm not going to give a lesson in front of you because you should only enjoy it, and if we have a lesson, it will be not with the public, you know? Wonderful.
让我给这些年轻的演员们上上课，但是呢，我应该是否认这个要求，因为我是既是一个歌唱家，也可以做一个评论家。可是，在一个晚上，我们不能做两件事。所以今天晚上呢，我要是对他评价了呢，就不能够唱歌了。所以呢，我就是说他唱得很好，让他的歌声给大家一享受。
So, ladies and gentlemen, now we are going to hear a colleague of me. He's a tenor, and he's going to sing from Gaetano Donizetti, Elisire d'Amor, Una furtiva lagrima, and his name is, please allow me the name, I don't say it so well, but it's Yu Ye Xin, tenor. And I want to take the possibility to say that, of course, at the piano, it has been Maestro Eugene Kahn.
può morire, si può morire.
You see, he doesn't need any critic. He's very, very well.
Wonderful.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Now, we are going to change to a baritone, and from Ruggero Leoncavallo, the opera I Pagliacci, singing the prologue, is the baritone Yu Ping.
He sang 下面我想欢迎于平唱选自歌剧《丑角》中的开场白。
Per ricordare
voce dove dissi, ora ascoltate come le svolgo. Andiam, incominciate!
Wonderful voice. And now, to finish, the last singer, an opera also from Giuseppe Verdi, which I start the program, from La Traviata, Sempre Libera, and it's going to be sung by the soprano Zhang Liping.
<laughs> 为什么还是自由的寻欢乐吧？威尔第曲选自歌剧《茶花女》。
Thank you.
I couldn't resist when it was coming the phrase for the tenor, of course, to join her. And I thought I was going to finish, but I think I'm going to sing for you one more thing before we go.
作为一个男高音，我不能拒绝我参加他的歌唱。然后再，我再为大家演唱一首。
I would like to sing E lucevan le stelle from Tosca.
Thank you.
Cuando los aficionados chinos hicieron un esfuerzo en sus escuetas economías para poder presenciar el insólito espectáculo que llegaba de Occidente, no tenían una idea clara de lo que iban a presenciar. En Pekín se sabía que con la compañía española viajaba una de las voces más bellas de este siglo. Cuando Placido Domingo empezó a cantar sus primeras canciones, sus almas se estremecieron, como se estremece la de cualquier espectador que en cualquier punto de la tierra tiene el privilegio de oírle. Para su primera actuación en China, Plácido Domingo eligió una antología de zarzuelas, género totalmente inédito en la República Popular. La zarzuela, que un miembro del Politburó comparó con el fuego y el agua de los manantiales, es la música que oyó cantar desde niño el tenor madrileño.